Chat in this video. Quite a lot happening on the past couple of 3 weeks. There's been quite a lot happening with me and tobacco. Today I'm going to be reviewing McClintok Syrian Latakia. Now this is one I've never ever seen this smoked on the community before. I kind of knew McClintok in the back of my mind, never ever looked at it. I'll tell you the story of how I come to be trying it later on. This is my Savinelli autograph. Still getting it going at the moment. I'm not going to review this just yet. It's alright. Well, I'll get it going a bit more in a minute. Anyway, tobaccos. Yeah, it's been quite an interesting couple of weeks for tobaccos. Had some... A lot of samples from Flankatanker. Tried a lot of those. There's a review for Merde de Chevel and Latakia Junction coming up later in this video. I've had that many tobaccos to do, I wouldn't be able to review them all. And I couldn't review them all at the same time, so I'll be a bit... so I got a couple in the can, and they'll appear in a minute. Well, they will come on after I finish talking. Now then, Jonathan Watt, very kindly sent me some Gold Rush the other day. Ashton Goldrush. Now, for quite a while, I've been looking for a Virginia, ideally a flake, but a Red Rum will do, a plain Virginia that I like. I'm not a big fan of Sam Gowis' full Virginia flake. I think it tastes a little bit like cardboard, but I know it's very, very popular. I'm not over keen on Dunhill flake either. The only plain Virginia flake I like, what I would smoke a lot, is Capstan Blue, which isn't available in flake form in this country. You can get it from the Danish pipe shop. And I might get some sometime. Anyway, I had this Gold Rush come through, and it almost got there. It was quite good, but not quite. It was so kind of, it's so unassuming, that stuff. Ashton Go, you could smoke it all day. You know, it's mild, it doesn't taste too papery in my mind, but it's lacking a little bit of fullness. Having said that, I nearly bought some, I nearly did, but I thought if I want anything like that, I'm probably going to go for St. Bruno, which has got a lot more taste in it, which is a Virginia mixture, not really a plain Virginia. But I might get some of it again, and it was quite good, Ashton's Gold Rush. If you want a plain, unassuming smoke, Ashton's Gold Rush is the one to go for. So I quite enjoyed that. Now then, Martin Flankatanker, who we all know and love, has asked me to show how I do my flakes. Now I smoke quite a lot of flake tobacco. In fact, sometimes I have a problem dealing with ready rub, to be honest with you. I can pack it right, I smoke more flakes than anything. So Martin's asked me to talk a little bit about how I do my flakes. Well, I myself, there are two ways of doing flakes. Some people like to fold them. Some people like to crumble them up. I go for the latter myself. Now, some tobacco manufacturers, and I do know McBaron, say this. They say you should fold the flake. I tried it a couple of times, and I find the tobacco doesn't burn properly. It gets too hot. So I break mine up. But I'll demonstrate it anyway. If you've got something like what this is Gareth and Hogarth. This is one of their flakes. It's actually one of the ones I sent you, Martin. I've sent you some of this stuff. This is Grasmere flake. Now you notice with Gareth and Hogarth flakes, they're very loose anyway. If you left that in the jar for a while, that would start to disintegrate, and you'd end up with, you'd finish up with a broken flake anyway. So it kind of lends itself to break itself up. It does so very easily. But to prepare them, what I do, I get a tin. Equip yourself with a tin, or you can just do it on the table and make a right mess. But it doesn't go down too well with the powers that be. So what I do, I get one of these. It's compressed, this stuff. So it's like concentrated. You know, you break it up and you've got, it doesn't look like you've got, when you've got a lot, when you break it up, you have. And I'm going to fill my Peterson System Deluxe with it, and I'll smoke it later. So what you do, you get it in your tin like that, or a container, plastic container, and just break it up, just tear it up. That's all I do. If you want to cut, get it really, really fine. If you've got a smallish bowl, and just rub it in between your hands, you know, get a bigger container and rub it up like that, really rub it out. But I find this works well. You can't actually see what I'm doing. But I'm just breaking this stuff up. Until you end up with something like that. And that's like a, you know, you can see how it's grown in size, isn't it? You only had a small flake there to start off with, but you got quite a lot now. And then you can just put that in your pipe and smoke it, you know. I'll just rub it out a little bit more. Just get it as fine as you can, depending on your bowl size, really. You just have to make a bit of a judgment. I'm just, you can't really see what I'm doing. I'm just filling it. It's no great problem, you know, there's no science to it or anything. So with Gareth and Hogarth flakes, they tend to lend themselves towards naturally rubbing out anyway. Their flakes, they just kind of, I think they just sliced off the cob. But I'll show you a different type of flake in a minute. There we go, you've still got that left in it, you see. So it's tobacco in concentrated form. And that's what I've got. And that's filled out quite nicely. All there is to it. Now that's with that flake. Now, if you've got something like St. Bruno flake, Peterson's flakes are like this as well, and I know that a lot of McBaron's flakes are. It's more of a pressed flake. It's made a slightly different way. And what you've actually got is this. It's that. It's more compressed. It's made in the machine, it's squashed together a bit more, probably more of a modern manufacturing process than Gareth and Hogarth, really. But again, it's the same thing. It's just concentrating, you just break it up and rub it out. You could fold that, but if you fold that into a biggish bowl, I think it will burn hot. You need two of these for an average bowl, actually. You need two. When the flake's that sort of size, you're probably going to need two. Depending on the size of your bowl, you'll have some left over. When I smoke this, I rub out two flakes. And put it in the same way, and that's good stuff. You know, St. Bruno flake, I think, is one of the best tobaccos there is. You can get the ready rub as well, but this is actually better. I think there's more flavour in it. So that's what I do with flakes. Once you've done a few, once you've had a few, and give it another thought, you know. That's flakes. That's about all I do with them, really. No problem at all. Right, I've sent packages out this week. Packages went out Friday night. Again, I sent some Gareth and Hogarth, a couple of their flakes, so you better practice actually there, Martin, to Flanker Tanker. See how you get on with them. I don't know if you've tried them or not, but see how you go with those. I've also sent you something you might quite... Did I send you that? Yes, I did. I've sent you some, and I can't remember what it is now, Artisan's Blend. Yes, that's the one. I'll say you might like that. You might like that if you're a bit of a Latakia fan. I'll say that. Jonathan, I've sent you a Syrian Latakia. I've also, and Debs, I've sent you a couple of pipe stems and a few other things. So that's some packages that have gone out this week. Now then, going back to tobacco, another tobacco, Martin sent me a load of tobaccos. I've still got most of them. I especially enjoyed the goat's butt. Very, very good. And one tobacco he sent me was Devil's Holiday. Now, I could have done with reviewing that, really, but I smoked all of it. I can't remember. It was very, very different. I'd very recommend that. If you can get it, Devil's Holiday was quite good. I think it's. I think Martin said it's a Cavendish. It's got a bit of Cavendish in it, which was quite nice. Anyway, right. What I'm going to do now is review this McClintok Syrian Latakia. Now, so I'll tell you that now. Jonathan One is a Syrian Latakia fanatic. Well, I'm quite partial myself. Well, it's not over generous on the Latakia front, but what is there is quite full. I'll read the packet description. Flying Bettos in German. I can't do that. Anyway, I've looked it up on the internet. It's a Syrian Latakia with Turkish and Oriental blends. So it's another Syrian Latakia. You know, it would be in the same class, but not as good, I wouldn't have thought, as Artisan's blend and the Dunhill, various Dunhill offerings, mainly including, I can't remember what it's called now, probably Early Morning Pipe, things like that. It's not unlike that. Nightcap, that's the one. And I've never actually had Nightcap, but I believe it's similar to Artisan's blend. It's lacking on the flavour front. There's no two ways about that. It's lacking. There's a lot of, I think there's a lot of cheaper tobaccos in this. It's alright though. It's okay. But there are better. There are certainly better Latakia blends out there, I think. I wouldn't recommend this as an introductory blend to Latakias. It's got quite a nice sour, kind of a dry gin taste to it. Kind of dries the mouth out a little bit, which I quite like. I'm wondering if this is probably better in a smaller bowl. This might be alright in something like a small size Peterson or maybe even a Falcon, something like that. Small billion maybe. Not bad though, not bad at all. Not bad at all. I'll smoke what I've got. Be interested to see what John makes of it actually. Very interesting to see. I look forward to seeing that one actually, John. Right, what's next? Let's consult this. Okay, tell me about that. Right, what we'll do next, there's a couple of videos coming up now. My reviews, how are we doing for time? My goodness me, it's ticking on. A couple of reviews now I've got coming up. I've had an account. there's some tobaccos Martin sent me, Merde de Chevel and the Latakia junction. Now, a couple of my subscribers, I forgot who it was now, so I was going to give him a shout out. One of my subscribers asked me about another piano piece the other day. I think it's... Sorry, mate, I forgot you do. You know who you are. He's asked me about piano pieces. I've got one in the can. I won't put it up just yet because it will saturate the timing. I mean, I'll never get it posted, but it's one in the can. Thanks for asking about the piano. Keith has also asked me about the piano a couple of times when I've been Skyping him. So there's another piano piece coming up. I've got one in the can. I'll post that up perhaps next week. Right, so what we've got coming up now is two tobacco reviews. So I'll see you after
that. Good evening, everybody. It's Martin here, Pipe and MG. Very unusual for me to make a video at night, actually.
normally do on a Saturday, but I got quite a few tobacco reviews here. I wouldn't be able to do them all on Saturday in the daylight, so I'm going to do a few of them in the evening. Firstly, thanks to Martin Flankersanker for sending me a load of samples, a real generous amount of samples. He specifically asked me to review the Latakia Junction and the other one, Merde de Chevel. I can't speak French. Both those tobaccos have been reviewed by Clangelin pipe smoker. I've watched his videos, of course. I've taken into account what he said. I'm, you know, hopefully going to contribute something with my review as well. I've been sat here for about 2 or 3 minutes. I'm smelling this, trying to sort out the smell. I mean, the first thing is for a 50% Latakia, you'd expect it to be what they call a real Latakia powerhouse, you know. But it isn't. It's surprisingly mellow. I think it must be the clever way. It could be the type of Latakia it is. It probably isn't a Syrian Latakia. I wouldn't have thought it'd be a Syrian Latakia. It's not strong enough for that. I think I've drawn the conclusion. It reminds me a lot of something called 10 to Midnight that I used to have. I used to buy from America a few years back now. A couple of times I had 10 to Midnight and quite liked it. That too was an American blend. It's very similar to this. Now, what I particularly like about it is it's got like a scent to it. Almost like a perfume, but not in the way you get from some English perfume tobacco. It's a bit different to that. I think it's just the Orientals in it. It's certainly not over strong. It surprised me when Martin said he liked it and I read a 50% Latakia. I thought, wow, you know, knowing what Martin smokes, I wouldn't have thought he'd like that. Anything particularly strong Latakia from. But this isn't. I mean, I've had some Latakias that have been, I tried Gareth and Hogarth's, I think it was a Balkan Latakia, and it was, far too strong. But this is very good. Very good indeed. You're getting that scented flavour. The Latakia really kind of forms a background. I'm kind of getting more of the quite sweet Orientals from it rather than the Latakia. But the Latakia is there. The smoky taste is there, but it's not that bad. Not that bad. It's nice. The Latakias are very, very good. It's got a smooth, creamy taste to it, almost as if it had burley in it, but I don't think it has. I think that's just the way it's blended. No problems with heat or anything. I'm puffing away on this as I do with the reviews, trying to get the flavours going in me mouth. I have no problems. Money is a Peterson system, so. Yeah, it's a very surprising to read that it's a 50% Latakia. I would describe it. Oh, I think it's more like a premier Scottish mixture or something like that. You know, you've got it's got cigar leaf in it as well. Perhaps that's where the creaminess could be coming from. It could maybe be coming from the cigar leaf. It's a very clever blend, anyway. Whatever it is, there's no two ways about that. It's obviously not. I don't know. John Patton, I think, isn't it? He's probably an independent micro blender or something like that. It's obviously hand blended. It's not made in bulk. Well, not in a factory, anyway. It's very good. Very good indeed. I don't know of anything that will be like this in this country. So when I think of kind of mellowish, mid-range Latakias in this country, I think of Squadron Leader, which doesn't come anywhere near this. Very good. I certainly recommend anyone trying it if they could get it. And say, but I think it's four noggins, I expect. So it is gettable, you know, it is gettable. And I'd recommend it. Right, well, I'll see you all again soon. This video will actually be going on with a load of other, well, two or three others on Saturday, so I'll be kind of live then, if you know what I mean. I'll speak to you again soon anyway. Cheers. Bye everybody. Martin here, Piper MG. Just got out of the bath. Hope you don't mind the dressing gown. Thought I'd do a tobacco review. I've been a bit busy lately, so I haven't had a chance to do this yet. We needed to do it all week. Martin, flanker tanker, and I think it's fair to say he's a legend in the community, sent me a stack of samples the other day. I won't be reviewing all of them. Honestly, wouldn't have time, but I've been smoking them all. The two he specifically asked me to review was the Latakia Junction, which I've just put up, and this other one, Merde de Chevel. We all know what the translation is by now. So I got some Merde de Chevel in a tin here. A tin. So I can have a good smell. Clearly it's a ribbon cup. Black and gold tobaccos in there. Latakia, Virginia. Smelling it, I don't really smell that much Latakia actually. No, I smell the Virginias and it's got like a pariki type smell to it really. It's quite vinegary. Anyway, I've got it in my, this is my, what was it? Aldo Morelli, that's right. Aldo Morelli, I don't think I've ever smoked this before in the community, on video. You can't really see it, it's quite nice, had it for a while. Semi-rusticated thing, you see the Morelli. Anyway, stoked it up. It's got the charring light going. It's very smooth, what I'm finding so far. Let's get it going again. Yeah, it's not a full-on Latakia. It's not as strong a Latakia as the one I tried previously to this that Martin sent me, which was Latakia Junction. Very nice, unassuming. Just blown about it from my nose. Because I've had a pipe full of St. Bruno earlier in the day. My taste buds probably can't pick this up. It's a problem if you switch around a bit, if you go from Virginias to English to Periques and things, and then florals as well as I do, you sometimes can't get your palate around the more subtler tastes that you get in this style of Latakia blend. I'm having a problem finding anything in this. It's very nice. It's very smooth. Must admit, a few years ago when I didn't like Latakia and or Orientals or anything like that, this is probably the sort of thing I would have more or less gone for. Probably a good first time blend for someone actually who's trying to explore traditional English tobaccos, which is why this is styled on. I think the Virginias in it are quite sharp, and I think that might be kind of masking the Latakia a little bit, which isn't a bad thing. Yeah, I must admit, smelling it, can't really smell a lot of Latakia at all. But it's very good. I can see it being popular. I can see this being popular in America. I don't think you can get it in this country. Keep going for a couple of... Well, you just have to bear with me while I try and get that. It's not unpleasant, but it isn't what I would go for. I certainly don't like it as much as I like the Latakia Junction. Look, I can imagine this might get a bit bitey after a while. It seems to be quite burning a little bit hot there. This is quite a thick-walled pipe, but okay, I've been puffing away at it a bit, so I've been trying to review it.
Probably let that cool down for a while. It could easily be an all day blend. That could, you know, you could probably. I've got to reserve judgment on that one, I'm afraid. I can't quite make my mind up on it. I'll have to have another visit to it sometime and maybe mention it when I post another video. But as far as review goes, so it's a very good Latakia Virginia. Good introduction for someone who's perhaps never smoked Latakias before. I'm having a problem picking up the Latakia, I must admit. I'll taste it. If I didn't know this was Latakia, I'd say this was more of a Virginia, more than anything. But very good, and I appreciate Martin sending it to me. I've returned the favour, he's sent me some of his favourite tobaccos. I'm sending him some at the moment. So he's going to try out some of those. And that's about all. I'll be back with you shortly. Cheers. See you in a minute. Hello, I'm back again live. Right, both of those tobaccos have been reviewed by Mark Clanguthin, pipe smoker. And I've just this second noticed that Keith Graham has reviewed both of them as well. And both those, all of those tobaccos reviews will be learned and masterful. So have a look at those as well. So that's that. Now then, how I come to try McClintok's Syrian Latakia, and I'm sure probably a lot of people have never even heard of it. I was, the other evening, I was thinking about preparing my tobacco order. I order tobacco once a month. I don't tend to stockpile it. I order it, tend to smoke it. If I want some more, I get some more. That's what I tend to do. I very rarely sell a tobacco or anything. And I was thinking, I've got quite a lot of kind of brand loyalty with tobaccos, really. I very rarely go outside of a brand. I'll try different Gareth and Hogarths, things like that. I tend to stick to the same ones, really, more or less. I think a lot of people do that. So I wanted to try, you know, something different, almost as if putting your hand, getting all the types of tobacco, writing them all down on a bit of paper, sticking the hat and just pulling one out, you know. And trying it, I couldn't really do that. So I thought I'll ask Jonathan Watt, if there's a tobacco out there he's always fancied trying but never bought for whatever reason, because it might be crap, you know, something like that. That's probably a lot of the reason why we don't try different tobaccos. So I PM'd him, and within half an hour he was back to me saying he'd always liked fancy trying McClintok Syrian Latakia. Now, I know a bit about McClintok. When I used to buy it from America, I think they make, I got a feeling they make cheap rolling tobacco, things like that. I wasn't even too sure that they make pipe tobacco, but it's on my smoking shop. So he suggested this. Now, I think John is a bit of a Syrian Latakia enthusiast. He seems to know quite a lot about different types of Latakia. He's very knowledgeable on all tobaccos, actually. So we did it, and it's worked well. It's almost like having a kind of what you call a backy buddy, really. I might try it on someone else later on, next month, something like that. And it might be sort of a good idea to perhaps try it on some of your subscribers. Ask, rather than suggest a tobacco to someone, ask them what they fancy trying, and then he gets to try something new, you do too. And of course, normal trading things apply. I mean, John's always sending me tobacco anyway. He sends me more tobacco than what I send him, so, you know. But, you know, work that out between yourselves. But it might not be a bad idea. It might start, you know, might get some new ideas going. As I say, I certainly wouldn't have tried this any other way. And the worst thing will happen is you'll get some tobacco you don't like. That's not... at least you've tried it. Anyway, right. So thanks for that, John. This has been interesting. And I'll speak to you all again soon. Cheers.